I don't know if y'all saw this gem of a photo drop yesterday. This is more photographic evidence of the IDF using human shields. Every accusation is a confession. Why are they doing this? Is it because they're sadists? Yes. And they cannot actually function as a professional military and do combined maneuvers. They cannot have dismounted infantry work in conjunction with their armored vehicles. Every Palestinian knows that all they do is roll around in their tanks shooting shit and they never get out. Why is this important? I'm going to explain it to you in the nerdiest way possible. With Warhammer 40K miniatures. Alexa, play anti-tank by Bolt Thrower. Okay, so you've got your blown out city because they're idiots and created Stalingrad 2.0. Like freaking sniper positions goddamn everywhere. You've got your armored column, right? 1, 2, 3, and you know these tanks and freaking APCs are busting tracks on the rubble left and right. And then you've got your infantry dismounts and covering concealment and blocking positions along avenues of approach. So blocking position for this avenue of approach, another one for this avenue of approach. And these are actually way more condensed than they would be in real life. You'd actually want to push these positions out so they have time to react to enemy contact and enemy incursion. You know, before they can shoot a dual phase RPG right in between the turret and the chassis. But honestly, there's nothing wrong with this amount of standoff from the armored vehicles. Anything's better than just sitting in a friggin' armored personnel carrier waiting to get picked off, because you'd rather just risk getting hit with an RPG than risk getting hit by a sniper. I mean, this is the same they did in Lebanon in 2006 when Hezbollah just wiped the floor with them. They refused to get out of their vehicles. All right, we're gonna take these guys off the board, and now unchallenged, a big scary two-man anti-tank team is gonna pop off a shot and then escape into the rubble like 2 seconds later. And as a former dismounted infantry guy, I'd rather get shot any day than to like burn alive in a mechanized coffin. But if you still don't want to get out and do your freaking job, you can always be super brave and do this. Yeah, and this IOF guy's like, oh, I'm totally getting laid when I get back from Gaza. And you know, it actually might, because it doesn't seem like any of these folks understand like concepts like courage or honor or whatever. But these two guys doing a really good job. Show no fear, keep a stiff upper lip. And to drive it home, yeah, Israel uses human shields. Israel uses human shields. And when they're not hiding in tanks and armored personnel carriers, they're hiding in apartment buildings, barricaded. Again, no security, and this happens. Wait for it. Shit, that's a lot of overpressure for such a confined space. That's a mass cow. It's definitely a mass cow. Mass casualty. And according to Israeli media today, 10 to 15 were brought in from the strip to the hospitals. And look, I've got my own mass cow PTSD shit, and I'd feel bad for you. I'd be like, oh, that sucks. But then again, you are using human shields and committing a genocide. So fuck you, as you were. Keep not pulling security.